The former singer with the Hollies and Crosby, Stills and Nash is a huge fan of the hit series, which features Scots actor Sam Heughan as Jacobite warrior Jamie Fraser. Music legend Graham Nash has revealed he ditched his microphone for his last tour of Scotland, to hit the Outlander tourist trail instead. The former singer with the Hollies and Crosby, Stills and Nash is a huge fan of the TV phenomenon, which features Scots actor Sam Heughan as Jacobite warrior Jamie Fraser. And the man who wrote the 60s classic Marrakesh Express made his own whistle-stop visits to locations from the series, including the site of the infamous Battle of Culloden in Inverness Shire. The 76-year-old explains, "I love Outlander. It's been such a fascinating series. That's what led me to the Highlands for the first time in August. I was totally enamored by the beauty of the countryside and the friendliness of the people." The TV series is based on books by Arizona-born author Diana Gabaldon and also stars Katrina Balfe as time-traveling nurse Claire Randall. And Graham admits he is full of admiration for the U.S. writer, who published her first Outlander book in the early 1990s. He says, "The thing I find utterly amazing is Diana had never even been to Scotland before she started writing her books. How did she even manage to do that? It is incredible. And now she has created this incredible Scottish tourism boom. I certainly know lots of Americans who are also heading to Scotland because of Outlander, which is fantastic." Graham, who was raised in Salford, Lancashire, started his incredible career in the early 1960s when he founded the Hollies, Manchester's answer to the Beatles, with his school chum Alan Clark. They enjoyed chart-storming success on both sides of the Atlantic with their pop hits including Just One Look, Bus Stop, and Jennifer Eccles. Graham, who will return to Scotland again later this month for the Celtic Connections Festival, recalls, "When I was with the Hollies we played in Scotland a lot. We did all over, but I remember the Glasgow Barrowland Ballroom the most. That was a great venue." But by the end of the 60s Nash had quit the Hollies and moved to America's West Coast after teaming up with David Crosby from the Byrds and Buffalo Springfield Stephen Stills to form legendary supergroup Crosby, Stills, and Nash. He adds, "I then played Scotland many, many times again, but this time with David and Stephen." Along the way he also became Joni Mitchell's lover and admits his relationship with the Big Yellow Taxi singer changed his life. He says, "I learned how she wrote songs. Where they came from. The songs we did with the Hollies were cute, catchy, pop. But when I came to America, I found my ability to write a melody with important words." Graham has featured in various versions of the group, which became Crosby, Stills, Nash and Young, with the addition of Neil Young in 1969, with Woodstock being one of their first gigs as a foursome. But it's their 1977 album Deja Vu the band are best known for, which features Nash's haunting anthem Teach Your Children. Graham is one of the few musicians to have been inducted into the prestigious Rock and Roll Hall of Fame twice. The first time was in 1997 for his work with Crosby, Stills and Nash, and then in 2010 for the Hollies. In the same year he received an OBE from the Queen. He says, "I don't really reminisce about all I have done. But there was a time when I was standing in front of Queen Elizabeth being honored with an OBE when I suddenly realized what an incredible life I have had. And, quite frankly, when I got the first proof of my autobiography Wild Tales a few years ago, I finished it and then said to myself, holy st, I wish I was him." But out of everything he's achieved there are a few pivotal moments that really stick in his mind. He explains, "The first time I ever heard the Hollies single Just Like Me come on the radio was one of those moments. Me and the boys had just left the BBC and were walking down the street when we passed two workmen fitting a shop window. They had a little transistor radio with them and our song came on there and then. Then the first time I sang with David and Stephen was an incredibly important moment in my life too." These days Graham is strictly a solo artist and has ruled out any return to Crosby, Stills, Nash, and Young. He insists, "No. That's all over now. We actually like and love each other and made great music together. What we once had is just not there now. They had a little transistor radio with them and our song came on there and then. Then the first time I sang with David and Stephen was an incredibly important moment in my life too. These days Graham is strictly a solo artist and has ruled out any return to Crosby, Stills, Nash, and Young. He insists, no. That's all over now. We actually like and love each other and made great music together. What we once had is just not there now. Now Graham is focused on his Celtic Connections concert before he plans to make another pilgrimage to more Outlander locations, including Downcastle and Stirlingshire. He says, Celtic Connections is a one-off show, so it will give a chance for Amy and I to explore some more. So we can't wait for the show and to hit the Outlander trail again.